I enjoyed treating my family to eat outside. That is the reason why I gained so much weight.
Shopping.
Yeah.
Happy though.
Mm, happy though.
Happy weight.
Happy tummy.
Happy tummy. Happy wallet.
No.
No. Money management, especially for college graduates, could be a really scary topic. College didn't really prepare us for it, and when we're young and naive, we think that we have all the time in the world. So when that time is done, we're thrust into the real world, fumbling with the possibilities, intricacies, and technicalities of managing money. I'm here in the Elements Residences showroom, and I've invited some guests with us to tell some tales and learn lessons as they look back in their after college years. I'm Hannah, and this is Money Matters. I'm here with Bang and Melvin. Hi, how are you doing today?
Feeling great.
Oh, looking great.
That's true, looking confident. Yeah. So nice to spend time with you and ask you a few questions. So in this episode, we are taking a trip back to memory lane as we revisit our younger selves. So I just wanted to ask, what were you guys like right after graduation?
Okay, I studied in Dumaguete, and after graduation, I went to Manila to look for a job. Luckily, I landed in sales. It was new to me, but very challenging job.
Me, kasi kailangan ko agad na makahanap ng work for my family. Mm-hmm. And siyempre, ito sustain din yung needs ko bilang first graduate. So, kailangan ko rin may papatunayan agad.
Ako kasi press after the graduation. Press.
Ang gusto
ko lang,
Albert.
Press talaga. Ang gusto ko lang nung that time, maging independent, maging free sa lahat ng gusto kong gawin. Mm-hmm. After my graduation, yun lang yung gusto ko. Enjoy ko lang yung sarili ko.
The world is your oyster. Yes.
Right.
Thank And you. It's also a very freeing experience right
yes.
after college, right? So what was the most exciting part after college?
The most exciting part after college, no more early morning travels from Marikina to Valenzuela. And it was the hardest part of college life. Mm-hmm. Imagine, gigising ako ng 4 o'clock in the morning, and then magpiprepare ako ng food. So, makikipaghabulan ako sa jeep plus the traffic.
I still remember what my mom told me when I was in college. Palagi siya sabi, mag-aral ka mabuti para makatapos ka mag-aral. So that yung magiging buhay mo is maganda. And after ng college mo, pagka-graduate mo, pwede ka na mag-desisyon para sa'yo. So after college, I feel like an adult because I am now independent. But at the same time, I'm still young enough that I can still make mistakes.
For me, the most exciting part about it is the independence. You get to do a lot of things, new things, and then you find a job, you get to earn your own money, and be responsible for it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the first experience of independence right after college, right?
Yeah.
It's super fulfilling. And one of the key steps to independence is really planning for your future, right? You don't really think about that right away, but it is. And so what were your plans for yourself when you got out of school?
Sa akin, wala pa talaga akong plano. Mm-hmm. Sarili ko nun. Ang gusto ko lang, enjoy ko talaga yung sarili ko. Kasi hindi ko nagawa nung nag-aaral ako nung college, and then nung after my graduation. Gusto ko lang enjoy siya. Gumimik sa mga friends, makabanding yung mga kaibigan ko, kumain sa labas, yun lang yung gusto kong gawin sa sarili ko.
Well, I considered going to graduate school, but then again, I realized I should get some or gain experience first, and then save up for a higher education.
Actually, kasi ako is, I came from Mindanao. So, isang probinsyano, which is na nangarap na makapunta dito sa Manila. Dahil dito nga yung opportunity, dito rin yung work, sustainable job. Eventually, nakahanap din naman ako ng magandang trabaho.
You really grew up here, no?
Yeah.
Change of environment and also finding your way through the careers and work in Manila. So that's very, very exciting for you, I'm sure. We have different plans after college. Some people study and some people work. Yeah. But in the Philippines, the main thing is always to help your family, to help your friends, and find a career that makes you happy. So after graduating, we get our resumes and we apply. So talking about jobs, I just wanted to ask, what was your first job? And what did you do after getting your first paycheck? And how did that feel, that independence?
it felt validating because I know I worked for it. What I did with my first paycheck was give part of it to my mom, treated my family to dine out, and also I bought some smart clothes that I can use every day in the office.
Investment, yeah. On yourself, yes, I yes, love yes. that.
Okay, my first job, it's also a sales. Yeah. Mm. So wala naman masyadong difference sa present work ko ngayon. Mm-hmm. And yung feeling yung makatanggap ako ng first check, so personally, I feel it was a sense of fulfillment. Mm-hmm. Kasi finally, mabibili ko na rin yung shoes na binabalik-balikan ko lagi sa mall.
Ano klaseng yeah. shoes?
Bradford.
You'll never forget those yeah. pair of shoes, di ba?
My first job was in Granton Marketing. So we sell discount cards office to office. So ito yung nag-mold sa akin sa sales industry. And then, first paycheck, half of my earnings, pinadala ko sa probinsya. Kasi nandun yung mami ko, nandun yung mga kapatid ko. So it's very fulfilling.
Yeah, giving back to your family, it's such a blessing, right?
Yes.
And so, after that first sweldo, we splurged on our family, our friends. How did you handle your next ones? So what were your spending habits like?
Well, you know, it's a different feeling knowing that you're already earning your own money. So I had this mindset before that I've worked hard for it, so I deserve to spend it. So mostly on weekends, I go on gimmicks, dining, unwinding with friends or family.
Ako, very excited ako nun sa sarili ko kasi this is my first salary. Eh. Gusto kong bimili ng mga gamit like bags, shoes, kumain sa labas. Yes, yun yung pinakigusto ko i-enjoy. Kasi hindi ko siya na-enjoy nung nag-aaral ako.
Balance of work and play.
Right.
That's how we make it sustainable, living this life. So what were your spending habits like? Because when the dust settles, then you're left with what? Right?
Naku, sobrang gastadora. yun ako nung time na yung mga first salary ko. I spent so much for myself. I enjoyed spending so much. And I enjoyed treating my family to eat outside. That is the reason why I gained so much weight.
Shopping.
Yeah.
Happy though.
Happy though.
Happy weight.
Happy tummy.
Happy tummy. Happy wallet.
No.
No. So after spending all of that, I was just wondering, did you experience any sort of consequences with your spending habits?
I realized the money that I was earning is too tight, meaning that it only comfortably covers my needs. Mm-hmm. Wala talagang ano room for savings. So even my wants, so hindi ako makabili para sa sarili ko.
Before it was my spending habits totally backfired on me. Mm-hmm. Impulsive buyer ako eh. So pag once na may gusto kong bibilin, binibili ko. Then it left me with no savings at all.
Mm-hmm. We weren't really taught how to save money back then, right? We were just really like, what do we do with all this money now? And so a lot of the kids who are watching or the younger ones that are watching are wondering, how do I even start? How do I begin? So if you can teach or tell something to your younger selves about money management, what would it be?
I would probably tell my younger self that I wasn't born rich. Mm-hmm. You know, you get to earn your money, but then again, you realize that you're not really that well off as you like to think. So borrowing money or asking for a loan from friends or family is not really a good feeling. So I would teach my younger self to save better.
Sa akin kasi, you need to buy all you want para sa akin. But kailangan mo magtira sa sarili mo. Oo, kailangan mo magtira sa sarili mo para sa future mo. Balansihin mo yung lahat, tapos naka-allotted lahat yung mga bagay-bagay na gagawin mo. Yun yung pinaka-importante para alam mo yung gusto mo at hindi mo gusto.
So parang per month, yes. Meron kayong allocation percentage for yourself,
yes.
For your family,
yes.
And also savings for a rainy day.
Yes.
Okay, I'm so excited to learn more from you in money management. So for the next episode, we're going to be talking about the present you.
Yes.
So I'm excited for that. Thank you so much for joining us. We do not become professionals overnight. Every professional in their field was an amateur once, young and naive. So is every adult who had to learn the hard way on how to properly use their resources during their younger years. And to all the young ones out there, I hope you got something from today, and hopefully you keep in mind that the earlier you learn about spending money, the better. To check if our guests really learned how to manage their money, join us next week for the next episode of Money Matters. Subscribe to the Elements Residences channel for more content like this. Also, check out and follow Elements Residences on Facebook and Instagram for updates and queries. Do you follow certain rules or certain principles to manage your money better?
For me, my number one management rule is creating a budget. Mm-hmm. So, ako, misis ko, we talk about the things that we have to pay, and we work around those budget, mm-hmm. so we don't have to overspend on anything.
Are you content with how much you have now?
Of course, no. I still don't own a Ferrari.
Oh.
Siguro pag...
Yan yung goal.
Yes.